Hello everyone, welcome to a new legacy video. Today I'm playing Merfolk. I haven't played Merfolk in a very long time in this in my videos, and I'm actually excited to play it. Merfolk did win a legacy PTQ at some point, and I told myself I would have played it, but then I kind of forgot about it, and then I saw the last legacy challenge result, and Merfolk went 7 on the Swiss and then lost in the top 8. Brazen Bar is a new card. Yeah, it's kind of just everybody's talking about this card in legacy because it is kind of cool in Delver mainly to just get rid of like Marit Lage and Chalice of the Void. In Merfolk, it's also like an evasive threat. Like, remember days when people were playing when they don't click. In this deck, is just an interaction because you don't have any, you don't have like Lion Bolts and stuff. You just play Merfolk. So the Brazen Barrog and the Petty Theft can be very nice. Although remember, it is not a Merfolk, so your Cavern of Souls can sometimes name something else like Rogue because you can cast both Brazen Barrog and True Name Nemesis. And I assume there's also a bunch of other Merfolk that you can cast, or maybe not. Yeah, no. Yeah. So, this deck is also playing Cora Helm Commander, another card that you don't see very often. It's basically a mana sink. It's a 2-mana Merfolk that, for 2 counter and sorcery speed, becomes a 3-3 flying. So, on its own, this card is an evasive threat. This list doesn't play Phantasmal Image, which is strange. Usually, you... One of the easiest way route of victory in Legacy is just casting... Well, F4 mismatching Nemesis? Oh no, only 3, alright. Is casting a true Nemesis and just copy it with Phantasmal Image as strong as you can and then win the game with that way. The deck plays 20 lands, 4 Mutavault, 4 Cavern of Souls, no Wasteland, which is kinda strange in a deck like this, but this deck does require mana. You have Waterlogged Gorge and Fiery Island as a canopy land to kinda avoid the flooding. Only 2 Cursecatcher, no Benthic Biomancer or other 1-drop that you see around these days, but only a couple of Cursecatcher. Chalice of the Void, which isn't like the most, this isn't the best deck for Chalice of the Void. It is just a good card that your opponent sometimes has to counter. You have some counters back up as well, Forcing Days. And then just a bunch of Merfolk, there isn't much to talk about the Merfolks. And the sideboard is weird. It has 4 Relic, 4 Dismember. I added 2 Surgical over the Repeals. But other than that, I just net decked it to the Vancer because, I don't know, they're kind of versatile, I guess. And then a couple of Forces. I guess you can go up to 4 Forces in the sideboard in Legacy, but I don't know. There's only 2, and I conveniently only own 2 on Magic Online. So I was happy to net deck on this case. And that's it, that's the deck. Let's head down to a Legacy Competitive League. But before that, I remind you, this is ChannelFireball.com, and you can support both me and ChannelFireball by using the link in the description if you want to purchase cards from ChannelFireball. And we are underway with round number 1. Do we have Land Vial? We don't. Our hand is also pretty bad. There's the Days plus 4. Yeah, this is not this Mulligan. This one doesn't beat anything. Alright, this one will try to beat something. I'm gonna keep this. What do I bottom? I was thinking about Fiery Islet. I was thinking about Fiery Islet here. I can also bottom a Server Gil Adept, honestly. But the problem with this deck, I think I'm gonna bottom a Fiery Islet. So the question is this. If I bottom a Server Gil Adept and draw land, that's bad. Although Fiery Islet kind of cantrips itself. So I think it is reasonable to bottom a Server Gil Adept here. Alright. Start off with Island Go. That was a tough choice. That was a tough choice. You could go either way. If we draw, you know, only spell, I'm glad I kept the third land. If I draw only, you know, 2 or 3 lands, I would have loved to get an extra Silver Gil Adept. Okay, unfortunately, the Cavern of Souls doesn't make Chalice uncounterable. You can't name artifact. So we're going to... Let's see what I'm playing against. Mr. Enforced does scream somewhat Timur Delver. So going for Chalice of the Void, it can never be bad, especially with this Force of Will backup now. I'm gonna play Fiery Islet and play Chalice. I don't wanna tell my opponent, hey, I have to cover, so you should use Force of Will now, or you won't use it anymore. You know? If you play Cavern, they definitely counter this. Oh, or maybe they just... Imagine they play Adnazan Tendrils and boom, they just can't cast 1-drop anymore. That doesn't mean game over though against another Tendrils. Again, they don't know what they're up to. They just have 2 fetch on. They could even be any control deck. Alright. I drew the 4th land, so that's bad. I'm gonna name Merfolk, and then I'm casting the true name Nemesis. Remember to add a colorful mana if you wanna make this uncounterable. Now the silver gill adept is worse, but this is more money efficient. If I draw a Merfolk next turn, I can crack the fiery islet and play silver gill adept. Or I can just, you know, cast the silver gill adept for 5. It's not pretty, but sometimes that's what you do. Alright, so Trinity of Nemesis now, right now is slightly worse because of Plague Engineer running around, but also the only one that doesn't exist in real life. Trinity of Nemesis was reprinted but with the same art in Battle Bond. I wouldn't mind, you know, it's different art. It also only exists in Battle Bond foil. It's like super expensive because they reprinted Mythic, which is kind of weird, but I guess that's the price you pay to get foils. Alright, is this a Abrupt Decay? Oh, Snowdeck. Snowdeck is now kind of cool because of Oko. People are playing Oko and Drowning Lock in Snow Control deck. It's definitely a deck that I want to explore. The Sultai with the new cards of Throne of a Drain. So cool that these formats still get new cards over and over. You know, despite it's like 26 years of cards and you still get, you know. Alright, there it is, Oko. I mean, what am I doing with Oko? Like, I think I don't know, I could counter it. Like, is it doing enough? I don't think Oko's doing enough. I think I'd rather keep 4/4, I don't know. Something else, or most likely I'm just keeping the Silver Gill Adept for something else. Oko does have a big loyalty, that is true. Alright, I'm gonna crack this Fiery Islet first. Okay, I guess I can name Rogue. Yeah, I can name Rogue now in case I draw the other thing. So I'm revealing a Merfolk. And I draw one card. It's an island. I would love to stop drawing lands. And then I attack Oko, Thief of Crowns. I don't think attacking an opponent makes any sense because the food, it just gives them life gain, so it's very hard to just go in a race with them. I might have underestimated Oko, but I also don't want to counter it because I want to see how it is. I want to see how, like, oh, this card is great, or, oh, you know, the Lion of the Veil would have been better, or just, I don't know, Brand 6 would have been better, stuff like that. Opponent shuffles the library with Ponder and plays a land. It's like obviously Ren 6 is good because we have you know, two ones over and over, but we also have True Name, which doesn't really care about those things. Okay, so I have 4 lands next turn again, so I'm not gonna be able to art cast Silver Gill Adept. I would love to draw a Merfolk. Yeah, just the 4th Silver Gill Adept wouldn't hurt. What's this? 2 mana. It's Gormagangler. I think I have to counter Gormagangler though. Yeah, I think I have to counter Gormagangler. Or Tazig or whatever it is. It must be Gormagangler. So I counter that just because you just counter race too well. Especially with Oko just turning the food into elks next turns. Yeah, I mean, maybe I should have countered the Oko. It's just gaining, I don't know, probably about 20 life this game, the Oko. Yeah, it's not great. This is not great. That's okay. I mean, you can't test how good a card is if you counter it all the time, right? So if they put a food, the Oko goes to 4. Yeah, it's a 3 mana planeswalker that has a lot of loyalty. Narset as well? Oh no. Stop playing planeswalkers. For 3 mana, that's great. That's great. Brainstorm. Okay. They already made the land drop though. I mean, playing around the spell pierce does make sense. And they pass. Come on, let's draw a Lord so I can kill a. I might just have to kill Narset here regardless. What do they do? Do they cast a 2-drop? Oh, Ponder. So they're in this Brainstorm X. And they Ponder. And they Shuffle again, okay? Yeah, so. Yes. Draw Lord. Nice. So, I don't even know though if I want to kill Oko. I think I'd rather kill Narset here. I think it's more important to kill Narset because Narset just gives them another spell. Where Oko, I mean, Oko's fine, but like it's only making food. Funnily enough, like what Oko's done is that it just has gained like 9 life so far. And it has made 3 food, it can give them 9 more life. So now 12 life.
But had I not attacked Elk, my opponent would have just made the food into Elks. If you don't know what it does, you probably already searched. I guess I should have showed it to you. I'm just used to play standard and like, kind of everybody knows what it does at this point. But I guess my Legacy aficionado don't know what this card do. It creates food tokens which have tap, sacrifice, gain 3 life. And then it also has a target artifact or a creature becomes an Elk without ability. So you can turn like a chalice into or a vial into an Elk and they all lose ability. Or food, as my opponent is doing. Now they have a 3-3. Hopefully, I don't know, they don't have a removal spell. That does look like a removal spell to me. And like not having a Phantasma Lee, man, just makes, I think, the A plan of this Merfolk deck in Legacy viable, which is the just Nemesis your opponent until the end. Just play like 2 trade, whatever, turn them Nemesis. Alright, draw. I think I'm gonna scoop. I could have won this game, maybe, but I think, maybe if I counter Oko instead of the, but I don't think it's the Oko, just that I drew, like, you know, 6 lands, and that isn't the best. Alright, so Vensta looks okay, everything else looks pretty bad. Relic could be fine, but I think I'd rather just stick with my Vensta. I don't know if I want the, I think Chalice is bad. I do think that Chalice is bad in this matchup. Days, I think, on the play could be fine. What do we want? Curse Catcher also doesn't seem great. I guess I could keep, like, a couple of Chalice. I think the Chalice on one. I mean, I can also Oko it, but, like, you say Oko my Chalice, it's not the worst. Or, I guess this... So, what does this member do? They don't have Tarmogoyf. They must have the Plague Engineer, though. I think I need to put these members in my deck. How many do I want to put? Maybe 2. Plague Engineer is very annoying. I'm just gonna put 4 and cut Curse Catchers. Yeah, let's do this. Let's go with this. Game 2 on the play. I think I'm gonna keep this end, although I don't feel the power. And I only have 4 vials. It's not that I can mulligan to a vial of Mortal Runes. I mean, I could lead off with Curse Catcher, but I don't think it's that good against a deck with Plague Engineer and very likely Dead of Winter. That is the list I saw, it had Dead of Winter inside, and they look good. Alright, I'll pass. I'm gonna go end of turn Ruffled Trickster. Hopefully there's something good, and then on top, play land, Lord of Atlantis, start for 3, and then who knows what's gonna happen. I have this force to counter Oko this time. Alright, Merfolk Trickster, a 2-mana 2-2 flash, not very many ability in this game, in this matchup, when it doesn't have creatures. And even if they do, they will need to be effect most of the time. Or static ability. Alright, Burst and Borrow, that's okay, draw. I think I'd rather go for Lord, though. Attacks for 3, if they go Abrupt Decay, sure, I'll take it. If they go Fatal Push, I don't want to counter that eye either. I haven't played Days Game 1, so hopefully the player doesn't play around and just lambs another time Alcon on turn 3 like they did in the previous game. Alright. What do you do, opponent? Do you play Abrupt Decay on my Lord of Atlantis or on my Merfolk Trickster? But also doesn't know that we don't have Wasteland in our deck, which is strange, but at the end of the day we have Cavern of Souls, which is needed, Mutavault, Vault, which is like, you know, avoid like the flooding situations, and you just can't play like, you know, 12 Corlos land. You have a lot of double blue card. So I think I agree with the choice, playing at least 16 blue spell. Alright, Brainstorm end of turn, there's no Terminus to put on top. Good old Terminus. It kinda, you know, it just disappeared. Like, you used to see Brainstorm End of Turn all the time into Terminus in board like this, but now it's no longer Terminus Reign. Alright, they do fetch. Hopefully I just hope they untap and play a 3 drop. That's what I hope for. I think I've been sitting here hoping for things for at least 2 minutes, and now finally something happened. I'm going to Dates the Fatal Push. I don't fight if they fight back. Because I need to just keep this force with like Dead of Winter. Or probably even Alco maybe. No, I don't think I can counter Alco. Just attack it down to one, and then alright, I don't play. Thankfully, they don't put me in that position. Alright. Okay, on top. Play the island. Attack for five. Plays opponent, don't play another removal spell, like an abrupt decay. Just take five and pass. It's very hard. I assume that Tropical Island and Snowcore Swamp will be tapped. I really don't like the Snowcore Swamp. I do like the Snowcore Rabbit Island from the Cold Snap set, but this land, I just don't like it. Alright. I think I'll have to play the Petty Theft. Run like an opponent controls. Alright, then I will not. I thought you could also bounce your own thing, but no, you can't. That's bad. Alright, so opponent goes to 13, which is still like 20,000 infinite life, basically. They used to have all the time in the world. I mean, I haven't really. I don't know. Okay, I just play my 3-1 for 3 at this point. It doesn't do too much else, so boom. Pick it up and didn't click. Without abilities. Actually, it has an ability it can't block. So much worse than Vandino Click. Much worse than Vandino Click indeed. But it does cost... it is a new card, so you're kind of required to put in your deck that these are the rules of Magic. So I, you know, very often work with the, you know, with the streaming, with the chat, right? And I always wonder if, for like a casual player, is better that wizards print good cards so that they're interested in having new cards around, or it's better if wizards just doesn't print any good card and you can play with your Nimble Mongoose and things like that forever. And I think the consensus was that they like cards like Brazen Borrower, cards like, I don't know, Mystical Dispute and stuff like that, just new addition from time to time. Force of Negation, for example, I think was pretty good in Legacy. Obviously good in Modern, because Modern definitely needed a card like that. Alright, what do they do now? Don't play Dead of Winter. Plague Engineer. Alright. Do you force back? You have Pyroblast? No. What do you have? Spell Pierce? Against me? Spell Pierce against me? I have like what? Like four spells in my deck. Alright, you got me. So did they kill this? Probably. Yeah, the name Rogue, they also stop. No, they don't stop True Name. They don't stop True Name, so that's important. Alright. What do we draw? True Name. Merfolk Trickster. That does let me attack for 2. It's not that bad, I think. I don't think it's that bad. 2 damage, and then we have a 3-3 Island Walk. Yeah, I think it's solid. Opponent's on 7. Remember, the Lord says other creature gets whatever he does. So this one does. This one is not island walking. So this island was made in... What year was that? 2007? Do you think this ice just melted in the process? Since the picture got printed? Probably, right? Alright, so I draw. And what is it? Boom. Boom! Island. Alright, I just can't... I guess I can't attack. If they kill my lord, it's gonna be a trade. This is just so bad. I just can't really keep playing this game. Like, this matchup is obviously hideous. The opponent is like removal spell and good cards, and I have like 2/2s for 2. Grizzly Bears and Counter Magic. Alright, so... They Snapcaster Mage managed to wrath my board. Must be nice. Then I play this island, so that if I draw a fifth land, I can finally cast my force of land. That would be amazing once that happened. Alright, got a 17. The 4 cards now, it's not really a big deal, only 4, you know? That's... What is the opponent? What do you do now? I just have to concede. There's nothing. Even if I draw true name, I can't cast it. Alright, let's see what I draw. There it is. Alright, instead of conceding, I will do the following play. I'll play 3 mana and I'll cast a True Name Nemesis. And then, wait. I have to choose first. Wow, that's cool. Alright, I'll concede. Good game. Sultaic, good cards. Let's be back for round number 2. Round number 2, we got a great hand this time. And if I could tell my deck a thing, I would tell my deck no more lands, okay? Let's just put all the 18 lands to the bottom of the deck. I don't even want Mirrodin anymore. I just only want to draw creature. Alright, so Cavern Island must be like the normal start these days. If you don't have Snooker Red Island, then you're not that cool in your deck. Sorry, if you don't have Snooker Red Island in your deck, you're not that cool. So yeah, Ponder. And we go instead Island Aether Vial, which only tells you one thing. That we are playing the fishes. Alright, 30 to buy exactly what we wanted. Oh wow, you have 6, so you don't even have a force of food. Usually when you draw multiple Aether Vials, like multiple Mox Diamonds, all you hope is that they counter it. But they never do it. They always know when you have it. Sorry, when you don't have it. But when you keep your colorless land, like mutable Aether Vial, they counter it for sure. That is what happened. They sneeze it. They be like, I smell Mana Screw with only one Aether Vial, counter magic. And they go like, oh, GG. Whereas now we just got Enjoyer, 2 Aether Vials in our hand. Opponent just takes 50 seconds on each cantrip, which is actually, you know, one of the good things in Legacy is that you can play cantrip and, you know, feel very good about it. You just play your cantrip and be like, oh, look how many choices I have. I am a good Legacy player, you know? That's one of the cool things of playing Legacy indeed. Whereas on the other side, you just draw a card for turn, tap mana, or in this case, tap Aether Vial. Alright, this could be, I think I have a glimpse of hope. I think we could play against Storm. It's not that this means that I win with this hand, it just means that we play different matchups. Matchup. Without this. Alright, so Preordain, taking another good old 30 seconds, and Scry bottom top. Alright. I would love to draw a Forca de Voluntade, as they say in Spain. Oops, what did I do? Oops, I clicked 2 instead of 1, which was not a good thing. I apologize with my viewers, but I'm not going to delete this video because of this mistake. As someone one time asked me in the chat, I will post it regardless. Alright, so I can still cast the Curse Catcher. Ooh, even if they just don't play around it. The rest. Ay. The rest doesn't discard the Curse Catcher. So what could have done was just play probably land go. Since I could have Brazen Borrow the Lands Eye Diamond if they had a weird a consequence of spells. Like if they play Lands Eye Diamond first and then they play it doesn't do anything. What am I talking about? I was just play 2 Aether Vial and then I had a Curse Catcher up the same way that I have right now. So, very likely it just doesn't happen that I misclicked, but you never know. So I have this Curse Catcher up, and they have a lot of mana. So the Curse Catcher very likely is not going to do anything. Okay, do they crack the Lanza Diamond? Because they don't know the top, so it would be weird if they do so. Okay, they don't. It's a very strange sequencing of spells. I guess they are trying to play around my Curse Catcher this way. But, alright, there are 2 cards in hand. Third line's that diamond. Alright, what's the last one? Is it an Inferno Tutor? Inferno Tutor, they can go. Alright, I'll concede. They can go past in flames and then it's over. Alright. The Quorum Commandeer did not bring it home. Alright, so we want these. The Surgical Dome really combo off with Chalice very well. So, all these cards I think are fine. In this deck, we don't have Echo in Truth. Usually, you used to just deal with, yeah. Alright, so I could cut Aether Vial, which doesn't seem very good to me. Also, we have to find cards to cut. I think our Hell Commandeer is not very good, and same worse for Twin Nemesis. I guess Brazen Borrow is also not great. I guess Commandeer costs 2 mana, so must be slightly better than the other 2 options. Alright, I think this is a fine sideboarding. Venser is basically a counter. I guess Aether Vial lets you. I mean, I don't have mana. I just don't use my mana anyway. So I just use Vial only to like activate Curse Catch, card mutable, and attack. It's more mana efficient, but I think I'd rather just keep a lot of creatures so I can pressure my opponent fast. I think Trunim doesn't do it very well. I mean, it does do it very well, but it's just slow. And Brazen Borrow, unfortunately, is not when they don't click. So I think I have to cut Aether Vial. Like I'm boarding in, you know, 10
non-creature. I can't cut other creatures, or my deck just doesn't function. The combo Child Surgical is not the most effective one, I have to admit. But hopefully, I know this was for Reanimator on the draw, because the Reanimator on the draw with this list without Surgical was like not very thrilling. All right, let's go for game number two against Anaxum Tendrils. All right, on the play. Because Venser can bounce a spell. Maybe you guys don't know about that, but Venser can bounce a spell. All right, should I keep this hand? I have a Chalice, which is pretty good if I draw land, and I have Relic of Progenitus, which stops. Doesn't stop much. I just can't cast my things like ever. Yeah, I should probably not keep this hand. If these were like one Aether Vial, maybe it would have been better. But I did board out Aether Vial for Relic. I think I have to mulligan this hand. It does have Chalice though. It's like one of the few interaction that I have with them. Although if they play turn one Discard spell, then the Chalice is gone, and like my hand is just mono cards that I can't cast. I think I have to mulligan this hand. Island go. I'm using Mulligan to get Discard spell is not great against Anaxum Tendrils. Sorry, Mulligan to get counters is not great against Anaxum because they just always have a counter. Oh, sorry, always have a Discard at some point, like before comboing off. So if you only find one counter, you just went down in cards. But I just believe that my hand was just not playable at the beginning. Like my hand, my starting hand was just not playable. That's why I Mulligan. I didn't Mulligan because it didn't have force, you know? I Mulligan because it just... All right, so my opponent doesn't fear the Wasteland, which is, it's okay. Maybe sometimes you can just get him with Wasteland in your deck instead of Mutavolt. I wouldn't fall, you know, for someone for putting Wasteland instead of Mutavolt, honestly. I don't think you have many more slots. All right, they don't shuffle. Sure, I'm just gonna cast my Folks. I would love to draw... Let's see what I draw. The island, that's fine. All right, brainstorm, sure. Personally like this, it's, I don't know, opponent could also just find like another cantrip. Like to go for the double cantrip here, getting rid of the extra redundant pieces, like if they have four reach, or they get rid of two or stuff like that. I love playing Anaxum Tendrils. It's a, you know, it's a deck that I very rarely play, but whenever I play, it was challenging. All right, on top draw. What do we draw? Maybe a Relic would be good. Another Lord. Sure, I'll play it on top for three. This could actually be a lot of pressure. Although my opponent just needs a duress and then go off. They have seven cards in hand. Like the odds of that Dynex are very high. Bayou, Duress. Okay, I'll show them my hand and then click F6. And then what do you do? King, Regal. It's very Regal, both the King and the Regal part, right? I mean, a King has to be Regal at the end of the day because it is actually a King. So I don't know if that could be considered an adjective for the King part. I wouldn't say this deck has performed very well so far. You know, I did misclick and blah blah blah, but other than that, I would say that we aren't really giving the best performance for the deck. If I wouldn't ask him what clunky draw, you know, we can't have another turn, but it is just hoping my opponent gets unlucky. Which isn't really a good place to be when you submit a legacy deck. Alright, I have 5 mana. I can go on Anaxum Tendrils, they can definitely get unlucky with that. Like especially if like all they have is another Tendrils, we're attacking here. I don't understand this, like, play Rachel first and then play Brainstorm. They did it before as well. Like, it doesn't make any sense. Just play Brainstorm first and then you play Rachel. I think. I mean, obviously, like, the deck is hard to play, so you can't just sequence. It doesn't really matter at the end. All right, what did they reveal? Lens of Diamond, okay. So they have now two Lens of Diamond and, I guess, a Infernal Tutor. Uh-huh. Yeah, so if the last card is what I think it is, they can crack the diamonds, they have 7 mana, can cast Passing Flames, 3 black floating, they cast Infernal Tutor,
it goes up to, so I got 3 floating. They cast past the flames now. Oh, tendrils. It was lethal. All right. Didn't need to do all the things. All right.
This was not even close. Both matches were not even close. So Zach was playing another format.
All right, let's be back for round number 3, hoping we can get some closer game with this deck. And if you didn't know, Channel Fireball, this video is offered to you by ChannelFireball.com, which you can find on ChannelFireball.com, as you could have thought about. ChannelFireball does also trade with you, not only, it doesn't only sell cards, so you can go to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to check out their price on your cards. Round number 3 is Sharkcaster Mage. Will you be so kind to give us a first victory? Not with this hand. Alright, guys, I feel it, this is the time. This is the first victory. We put in the bottom of an island, we got turn 1 vial, turn 2 chalice on 1, and then we just boom, 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 start playing 2-2s for 2. And our opponent will be buried by our fishes with the trident. Alright, so I'll keep 6, bottom of an island, done. Let's go, stop, let's remove the stopping upkeep, I don't need it. My deck doesn't require any stopping upkeep, we have no fetch lands. Alright, land ether vial, your turn. Your turn. Or as I've heard saying to someone, probably English people, yours. And I was confused. Alright, Savai, I think we can be there in power level now. Alright, give her runes. Untap. Put in the stuck always. Yes. Alright, I'm gonna play Chalice here. I don't care if they play Giver of Runes and maybe not the mini one drop. Like, if they play a Ponder, I would have slammed the Chalice, but since they don't, I could think about it, but I think it's okay. Alright, opponent, but let's just do this fast at least, please. Alright, yes. Alright. Yep, great. Ether Vial. So now that I cast the Chalice, I can't cast it anymore. Sure. Alright, Chalice is in. Your turn. Ether Vial on 1, we have only 2 Curse Catcher to put in, which we can do resolve in the face of a Chalice of the Void, which is funny. 2 mana Scavenging Goose, let's go. Giver Runes is definitely annoying, but yeah, we don't even have the Spreading Seas in this deck. In Modern, you do a Spreading Seas your opponent's land, so you kind of go their way. Okay. I'll play 1 creature. Now I'll pass. I'm afraid of blocking if they attack with the ooze. They can't cast Plow, so I don't really know what can happen if they attack me. So maybe I should attack just to force some action so that they have to tap the Mother of Runes, the Giver of Runes, sorry. And then I just attack for 6 or something. Yeah, Mox Diamond. Alright. Discard a Wasteland. Nice. Not a what? Sajir Step. Oh. 1 card in and they'll cast a 5 drop? What is this? I'm afraid. Oh, Zenith. Sure. Yes. That is unfortunate. They have now a Knight of a Reliquary. That is a 4-4. When I played that deck, the Knight was so bad, but my opponent managed to make it sound very cool there. Alright, let's put into play a Master Repeal of Trident. Now, do I want to put the Vial up to 3? I think so. So if I draw 3 Nemesis, I can cast it. We have 2 islands. And this deck, this is not Modern. You have actually a lot of 3 drops in this deck. Alright, I'm just thinking about what I was doing. Alright, okay. So Vial goes to 3. And then this means that I should just upkeep nothing, because I didn't put the stop. Yeah. I just auto-yielded the thing there. Alright, what do we do? He loses all the abilities, it says. So what I can do is attacking both. Opponent blocks with a knight. I tap it with the Merfolk Trickster that protect it from blue and I get screwed. So I'll play Lord of Atlantis and pass. Alright, opponent will eventually make a 20-20, and how do I deal with that? Probably the short answer, guys, is a pretty brutal one, is that I don't. Unless I draw petty theft, the prison bar. At that point, I can set up a scenario where end of turn, I tap the giver of runes. So when they go for a 20-20, I can petty theft it. Gaddukdig. Okay. I can't cast Force of Will anymore, or Chalice anymore. Can you imagine Chalice on zero? That would have been cool. Would have slowed down my opponent a lot here. Alright, I think this Aether Vial can stop now. Now, on three, it's safe. Okay, that is a good draw. I'm gonna pass here. Although, I don't think I can... At the end of turn, I can tap this. Maybe this. Yeah, maybe this is better. Yeah, end of turn, I'll tap the knight. Okay, that's a testament stage. That's the first stage of the combo. Alright, another testament stage. I guess I got lucky there. That he didn't draw the second part of the combo instead of the Taspian stage. Alright, let's play Merfolk Trickster. And as I said, I'm gonna target the Giver of Runes. If I target the Knight though, I can attack. I think it's better, yeah. I wouldn't mind just be afraid of doing a... Alright. So, yeah, maybe I should have tapped the Giver of Runes. That way I can top deck something. Whereas now I just don't have any out, I think. If I can top deck Brazen Barrer, that would be still cool. It would be still good enough because I can chump block. I don't even have Sejira step anymore. Alright, so we need to top deck here. Brazen Barrer would be the best draw by far. Alright, let's do it. Not because I can bounce the token because they'll give her runes, but oh, Korahim Commander. Nice. That can also get flying. Unfortunately, though, I can't make it fly because I can cast it or putting counters on it. My creatures don't fly. I'm just going to attack with all, see what happens, and then concede the game. Actually, I'm just going to concede the game. I don't want to win this way. Whatever. Let's just attack with all creature. I'll just show you in case you don't know the combo. The combo which my opponent is doing is the Taspian Stage combo. So my opponent will... Also, I can get information if they... Alright, they do have Dryad Arbor. That's good information to get. Alright, this is enough. Let's just copy the attachment stage and keep the land with no counters. And then they have a 20-20 flyer. Marit Lage. And then they attack me to death. Alright, so we have Submerge. Venser. I can also have Relic. Aether Vial... Sorry, where is it? Chalice looks bad because I don't know, I didn't play a single one drop. Other than the one on the first turn. Because this deck is not, like, in this deck, Chalice doesn't stop your opponent one drop. It stops, like, your opponent, like, cantrips, basically, because your opponent still plays a one drop, because they play Chalice on two. And then, like, what my opponent did was just as bad it could be against the Chalice, because I played a one drop, and then I just didn't draw any more two drop. Sorry, any more one drop, yeah, that's what I was about to say. All right, so. Merfolk Trickster looks okay, I mean, it can buy me a turn. I don't know, Chris Catcher looks... I don't know, I just think it just doesn't look like Legacy playable to me. Maybe for this domain, I think 3 is okay. Yeah, let's go with 3. Back with game number 2, seeking for the first game win. I will keep this hand made with creatures and lands. Island and pass. Probably think Korahil Commander is the best on turn 2 now. Simon Safekeeper. Alright, Holy Rod hits the field. I think Korahil Commander is the best. So that on turn 3 I have to decide if I want to play True Name or if I want to play like Lord and give a counter on it. Probably go with True Name though. Okay. Sure. So I'll go to draw step. Okay, I think I'm gonna go True Name. Very. I'm just gonna curve out like a normal Merfolk deck. 2 drop, 3 drop, 2, 2 drop. Hope that's enough. Hope that's enough. Alright, what do they do? Hopefully they don't have like sweepers. I don't know. I mean, they could have anything that are like green white, but they could have Wrath of God for what it's worth, but I just don't believe it. Don't believe it's okay. Ancient Tomb. Wow, there goes Zenith for Knight again. Okay, just Knight. Okay, this must mean they don't have any lands because otherwise it would play any other land. I guess the other land could be a Dark Depths. All right, so I can go double Lord. This becomes 4/4. I'm putting in Depths like hard blocks in general if I do that, so I think I'm going to do that. And then I just keep Merfolk Trickster for Thespian stage. For Merit Lage. When I can double block. Actually, no, they. When I can also just block with the Knight and sacrifice a land. Sacrifice two land to give X proof? No, I don't think that's possible. And I'm like, I would love to trade this for two lands now. So I'm okay with that. Grand Commander is just a 4/4, and that could sacrifice lands to make the Knight whatever X proof. But that just enlarged the Knight that way. But again, I'm just happy to happen. I think this card, like, both me and my opponent are doing some underpower things, I believe. And I believe that me, I'm doing the better underpower things. But I don't know, I just, Knight of the Red Inquiry feels like, ooh, feels like so 2015 to me. I mean, it is cool with Dark Steps and Thespian Stage. Like, my opponent comboed it off last turn with it. Okay, they pass again. Now, it is kind of scary, so I could just, I don't know, just put 4 counters on this thing. I mean, it is possible that my opponent... How do we draw first? It is possible that my opponent goes for... the combo. So maybe want to keep this. Although, they have Sylvan Safekeeper. So if they go for the combo, they just win. So I'm just gonna make this a big flyer and attack with all. How does that sound? Maybe just small flyer is enough. Like they could, I think a small flyer is enough. Like the true nemesis can be blocked because of, you know, it's a true nemesis. And this one, they can do what? Again, if they go 20/20. I'm very in doubt here what to do. Because if I make the Corallian Commandeer a 6/6. Like, I don't think it matters too much because I have Trunum Nemesis that gets through for sure. Unless they go like Zeus Persecute. I don't know what I'm talking about. I don't know what's happening here, guys. I think it could just be the 20/20, but if I attack with all, they can't make 20/20 and block. I'm just gonna attack with all. I don't put the last counters on the Corahim Commandeer. I'm just gonna talk with it all here. Maybe what I should have done was just main phase Merfolk Trickster. Alright, let's see. Because, like, if they make the 20/20, they have to tap the Knight first, I'm pretty sure. Unless they have double crop rotation. Alright, they do have crop rotation. Sure. I don't know. I don't know what's happening here. I'm very curious to see what's happening. Obviously, I can't level up in as a sorcerer. Sorry for the noise outside. I'm trying to... talking over it now. So crop rotation gets a Thespian stage, and then what? And then they have to go crop rotation again for the 20/20. Then they do what? They can't tap the Ancient Tomb because they die to my Nemesis that way. So they have to just. I don't follow them. I mean, they have to not tap the Knight. I don't think they can. Even if they have a crop rotation, they can't have 3 blockers this turn. That's what I believe. Although I don't know what their hand is. That could also go plow. I didn't consider that, actually. I didn't consider spells. But I could also play spells. So, yeah, let's see. I'm very curious. Very, very curious. Maybe I should have played the Merfolk Trickster pre... I don't know. This is, like, one of the things where, with perfect information, it would be very safe, but... Okay, the path to exile my creature. Okay. I'm very glad I made this fly, at least, now. Cause this is still lethal. We have 8 power flying. But it didn't path to exile the Corham Commandeer, so they have a plan here. And they can like float 2 mana off the Ancient Tomb and then make the 20/20 with the Dark Depths. And then one forest up, but that still doesn't answer the board. Because the Ancient Tomb puts them down to 0. To 4 and then to 0. I did play a Path to Exile, so they must have a plan, right? They don't.
And your grinder wins. Alright. Good game. It was very, very close, actually. I think my opponent was just one life short of like killing me, because if there were one more life, they could have made a 20/20 block the one thing and block the other thing and then just kill me on the backswing with the Sylvan Safekeeper. Actually, the Sylvan Safekeeper dies in combat, so I can then tap the Marit Lage in the next turn. But they do have Sylvan Sejiri Step. So yeah, I think if my opponent had one more life, they would have won the game. Alright, stand by this sideboarding. Let's go for round number 3. I could also consider Dismember, because I play like, you know, some creatures. But the problem with this deck is that if you start cutting creatures, the deck just falls apart. Relic could go out, although it does seem pretty good with both the Avish Reclaimer and the Arakai. Alright, this is obviously Mulligan. I could go down to 5, but I do have a redraw, plus Submerge is pretty good. I think I'm going to keep this End and Bottom of Days. Yeah, I'm going to keep the True Name. At the end of the day, True Name is like one of the best cards in the deck, and you can just draw Vial to fix the double blue, and this deck is like 16 double blues, not that unlikely. Alright, Shark Caster Mage. Let's go. What do you do? Alright, so I'm gonna probably play a Relic, start exiling some things, and then just pop it off on turn 2. If I find a blue land, I just play a Silver Grill Adept. Actually, no, the reason why I didn't bottom the True Name is because of Silver Grill Adept. It's pretty random, it just happened to be that the reason, but it is in fact a good choice. Alright, so Savannah, give her runes. Ah, yeah. Give her runes is so annoying as me, because I just don't have removal spells. Oh, alright, this one does cast the Silver Guild app, so I'm going to cast it. Maybe Merfolk, and playing the Relic. Maybe Merfolk played a Relic pass. Now they have a Giver online, which will mean that I can only get in with like True Name or something else like that. Wait, this protects from Coralless as well, right? Yeah, the Giver protects also from Coralless. So the Mutavolt can be also killed and blocked. Alright, Knight of the Reliquary does resolve. Even if I had Daze, I couldn't have casted it because I don't have any island. Alright, so we start thinning the Knight at least. Knight thinning. Alright, that's the island, so it's all good. I'm gonna play Silver Gill Adept. I'll reveal its True Name and then I'll pass. Should I play Submerge? That was a mistake. Sorry, I should have played Island, because I could have been able to play Submerge. If one controls a forest and you control an island, you have to control an island to be able to play Submerge for 0. Opponent does have Giver of Runes, but still. Like, if opponent now plays a fetch land, I could have submerged a Giver of Runes. Instead, now I can't do it, because I played the Mutavolt instead, which was definitely a mistake. I didn't consider that line. Alright, what do they do? Now if I garrison in if the Giver of Runes, they have to shuffle. Search for libraries, there's not a mate. Like, you have to shuffle. Alright, Dread Arbor, interesting. They have 2 mana up, I guess they want to, I don't know, kill something. Alright, let's play this and pass and start just playing True Name, because again, this is like what you do in Legacy, honestly. With Legacy Merfolk, you just only cast True Name. It's like the name of the game. And this Relic stays here. Chills. Alright, now I should probably just submerge to Giver of Runes. I think it's a good play. Because, yeah, actually, I wouldn't have submerged to Giver of Runes last turn because opponent could have just get a Sejiri Step with a Knight. Whereas now they just can't. Now they have to accept the submerge. I mean, they could go Crop Rotation for Sejiri Step, but I don't know how far does that go. Alright, nice. So, that does resolve. So, we successfully dealt with the Giver of Runes.
They get a Tespian stage. Alright, that is happening. My opponent will combo off soon. But at least now we give ourselves the odds, the possibility of top decking an answer like a Venser or a Petty Theft. Or what else? What else is an answer to that? Not sure. But I can do it now though. They need another mana to be able to combo this turn. So I'm gonna tap. Alright, drawing island is good here. Actually, no, it isn't. I could have just gone cavern for wizard and cast Venser. Yeah, I'm just gonna play land, true and Nemesis, and leave up an island. Which we'll use probably to just crack the relic. Yeah, my opponent cannot combo off this turn. Or maybe that's not true, actually. Because I can float mana, make this into a Tespian stage, and then kill Dark Depths, and then pay 2 mana to copy it. Alright, I could have done it. Alright, so I should have sacked a relic to get the out. Alright, hopefully they play around it, I guess. They don't look someone who play around stuff. Oh, crop rotation. Okay. And now they have Knight of the Reliquary. To be even more sure about it. With a... Sejiri step up. Okay. Alright, it's a Marit Legion. That's 20 damage coming in. Yeah, I mean, what could have drawn? If I crack the relic main phase, fearing the 2020, I drew a force, so I could have forced the crop rotation. That would have been very good. That would have been very good indeed. Instead, I play true name because I miscounted. Alright, it wasn't very good showing of the deck. I'm sorry. I'll play one more. On the play for round 4, looking for the first win. It's not gonna happen with this hand. Oh my god, guys. Alright, keeping this one. I think I'm gonna get rid of Chalice and maybe 2 drop. I think I like to cut like this, yeah. I think you need True Nemesis with this deck. Like the power level is just too low to do it on your own with the 2/2s. You need True Name. Alright, Ancient Tomb, Chalice please. Aldrazi Mimic. Sure. Can't really counter an Aldrazi Mimic. Alright. Let's put up to 1 island. Lord of Atlantis. Go. Not countering that means that also I could cast the Lord of Atlantis. But I think mainly that I can just counter like the real card like Tunnel Seer and stuff like that. Did I pass? It's been so long that I haven't seen a Grazi Mimic. What's the word for this animal in English? Papiro. Alright. I put all loyalty. Sorry, loyalty. A counter on that. Alright, I guess I drew all my lands. Who needs the vial after all? Maybe I was supposed to bottom the vial? No, I mean, I wasn't. I just had 1 land. How can I bottom the vial there? Alright, Trinity Levels is very good against Aldrazi. Okay, do they have a land Tunnel Seer? I kinda hope so. Or Borg? Sure. Right, I'm satisfied with my not dazing that. I could have seen a Spirit Guide here and pay, but they would only find an island now. Vial, I think 2 is fine. Sure, gonna go Mutavault, attack for 4 pass. Next time we double the is a 3/3. We want to get to 5 this game, but I think my opponent deck might be not very ready for the true name. Okay, so we play 4 dismember, maybe Vensers. Definitely out of the chalices, and I guess Curse Catcher again. Maybe Dates. Yeah, let's go with this. Alright, I'm on the draw with a one lander and the vial. I think that's enough to keep. Hope my opponent doesn't go choice on one of the play. That would be upsetting, to say the least. I don't think I can mulligan this hand. I have a vial, which is very strong. And like, this member is a good cyber card. Alright, guess my opponent heard me. Heard me saying that. Alright, go Merfolk, go. Now we need to, I don't know, just draw lands. 20 lands in my deck. Tonnet's here, please. Tonnet's here, please. No, endless one. If the Tonnet's here, that'd be great, because I could dismember and just cycle the draw step. I think I'm not going to dismember now, because if I... This is not a problem. This masher could be. Alright, now I have to dismember. Not that going to discard is bad or anything, but I don't know. I guess I should have just discarded Vial and pass, and then I could have dismembered Smiradi's Masher. Wasteland? I don't even use it? Oh, it's just no respect. I'm over here, Mana Security, don't kill my land? Alright. Let's go to game number 3. Yeah. Let's submit this. Maybe on the play one days. Although they play Cavern. I think Force of Will is okay because he can counter like Umezawa's Jit and like all this dust and stuff like that. I think every other card is pretty good. I think I'm submitting this. Alright, on the play for the last match. Maybe I could have also cut Curse Catcher, but I think that having a bot is somewhere relevant. Okay, this is a 6 hand. This is gonna be a keep. I'll bottom a Murph, I got the Pearl Trident. And I tried to go Super Guild Adaptive to True Name. Killing their creature. Hopefully this aggressive curve will be enough. Yeah, I think I bottom this. I can't get Gradient and bottom an island. If I just miss the land drop. If I just miss the land drop and don't play Trunen and Nevesis on 3, it's just too bad. I might even consider dismembering the Mimic here. Can you possibly play and draw your Chalice now in this game? I would love you to. How many 1-drop do I have now? Oh yeah, classic 6. Alright. So... Opponent kept 7 like us. No, that's not true, we kept 6. Alright, Ancient Tomb, please challenge me. Come on, don't play Mimic. Spyglass? Sure. It's new art on Spyglass. I'm not really a fan of this art. I guess it's nice. But it does look like something... I don't know. Strange. That is strange indeed. Alright, name Mutalt. Alright, now Mutalt, you are not anymore a worthy land. But you can still out for colorless mana, which is all I can ask you to do next turn to be able to play my Trinum Nemesis. Alright, 3 of a kind. Guess opponent. Hopefully, please don't Tunnel Seer me now, because I need to cast my True Name and win with it. Please just play a land and pass. Alright, that's perfect. Okay. Ratchet Bomb is an answer to my True Name, though, must be said. But, I mean, what am I... Actually, I was about to say, what else am I going to do? I might just play a Silvergate Adept. Yeah, that's also reasonable. Right? Because I leave this member up. Oh, no, you know what? I don't care about leaving this member up. I'm not playing against it. I have 3 of this member, so if my opponent draws a Tadnus here and plays it, I'm like, whatever. Like, this means that my Silvergate Adept isn't, like, as good as anymore because I don't have Merfolk in my hand, but my deck is full of Merfolks. I just always make sure to sideboard in a way where my deck is full of Merfolk. Like, did I sideboard out of the Merfolk? No, I didn't. Maybe I should, and that's the way I'm losing, I don't know. But I just think that... Alright, Blast Zone. There's so many ways to kill my Trunum Nemesis. Alright, did Tadnus hear me? It's fine, I have 3 of these members in my hand. Okay, they don't even Tadnus hear me. I guess they set up for, I don't know, they kill my permanents. Okay, that was a very bad draw. Luckily, though, hopefully, though, they cracked the Spyglass, so I can attack with Mutalt. Alright, let's play Vial and pass. Unfortunately, I can't cast the regular Adept. Not that I would, even if I could, probably. I don't know, we'll see what happens here. I put this on 9 already. Ancient Tomb is definitely damaging them. Like, they're 9 and they really haven't done anything. Oh, wow. Not a loyalty counter? Okay, they don't. Sorry, I don't know why I say. Why I keep saying longer counter? I don't understand. Another counter on the blast zone. I was going to say, oh wow, another ancient tomb activation, but my mind said loyalty counter. Okay, they use Seaman Spirit Guide to put what, two counters in the blast zone? Sure. Alright, so this way they can crack the true name. Fine. Fine. Alright. Yeah, successfully. So they have to lose two more life to do so. Oh wow, this must have been like the most annoying true name nemesis ever. They use the Seaman Spirit Guide. They tap this like two times because now they have to pay three mana to crack the blast zone. They destroy a land. So at the end of the day, this did a lot. I'm very glad I played it over. What was the other option? Oh, yeah, Super Guild Debt. Oh, waste this. Okay, we can't waste land, I guess. Counter on the Vial, very important because the Vial can't cast Super Guild Debt without needing to discard. Sorry to reveal a Merfolk. But I wouldn't mind drawing a Merfolk regardless. Sure, unfortunately I can't activate the Mutavault because of Spyglass, so I'm just gonna get in with my two creatures and pass the turn. They're probably gonna die now of a horrible death. At least the Trunim will. Super Guild Debt, I believe it's not gonna die, because if it dies, my opponent just cracks the Spyglass as well. Alright, so they take 2 damage off the Ancient Tomb, sacrifice the land, and they get a 3 life. But that did successfully deal with my Trunim. It would be a shame if I just go top 3 Trunim now. Actually, it would be also wrong, because my opponent does Ratchet Bob up. Okay, we pass. Opponent's on 3. Opponent is on 3, and we're still on 20. And we have 3 Dismember in our hand. So it's very important to be on 20, because these Dismembers cannot be cast. Unless they play Urborg. If they play Urborg, then I can't cast that. Okay, wow. They get a 2? Sorry, they get a 1? Sure. Please, please do it. No, what are you doing? No, opponent, just play Smasher. I guess that's a reason to keep Island in my hand. But I was wondering, if my opponent kills the Vial and I draw land, then I want to pay 5 mana to play Silver Guild Adept. Opponent's deep in the tank there. They're like, what should I do? What should I do? Should I play Thunder here? Should I play Smasher? Should I play... Umezawa's Jit? Should I crack this Ratchet Bomb to unlock your Mutavault now that I drew a Wasteland? Maybe. Maybe that is a good play. Like, what I think is gonna happen is I play Adept, so I attack with Adept, I crack the Bomb on 2. Oh wow, they don't do anything. Sure. Now if I draw land, I'm gonna save it, I think. But I would love not to draw a land. Okay, Force of Will. They do have a Cavern. Mm-hmm. Do they crack the Bomb? Alright, they crack the Bomb, okay. I'll take my, I don't know, 3, 4, 1 plus a lot of damage. I'll play Adept to draw a card. Oh no, I was thinking either land or a blue card makes me a force up, but I managed to draw an Aether Vial. It's very unlucky. Alright, it's okay. Now I guess I have a card to discard for free to the Smasher. They're on 3 life and they have a 2-1. Okay, they can now cast the Thanatseer. But that would be that would leave them dead to my Mutavault. Because my Mutavault is active. Alright, I pass again. Sure. Okay, they don't pass anymore. Okay. That's not stay on 2. Oh wow, we won the game. Woohoo, guys, we're en route to 2-3, and there's a prize for 2-3 now. That's 50 play points, so let's play for that. For the last match, we're up against the Red Deck Wins Fan, which could throw back the good old match, Merfolk versus Goblins. Although, if you look at his hand, he doesn't really have any Merfolks. Okay, Chancel of the Annex. And this is going to be a chip. It's going to be a fast one, a quick one. Chancellor has been revealed, has entered the reveal zone. We do have a lot of interaction. But that's probably not going to be enough. I mean, it's funny, but like, I don't think counter magic is what beats the reanimator deck. Alright, pull the Delta. And you may wonder, what it is then, Mengu? I think it is make deck basically nothing. And then plus Cyborg Hate. Sure, and you know, I can go like Delver, Flip, etc. But if they kept 7, Very close, you just can see it, because, I don't know. Alright, never mind. So, I'm thinking about it, if they have the Entomb, they have to play now. So often, I see people playing Entomb in your opponent turn. Cabal Therapy themselves. Sure, I can't counter Cabal Therapy. I just, like, there's no way I can. I mean, I could just throw four cards to counter Cabal Therapy, but... Alright, as I said, it's very hard. Now they have two counterman. Sorry, now they have two reanimation card for that. I guess they're... I mean, they didn't get chance Grazebrand, though, so maybe there's a chance. Alright, I'm gonna go Island and Pass here, so I can cast Aids on the Exhum by paying the mana from the Chancellor. Please cast Exhum and not reanimate, please, please, please. Pretty please. And the Mask. Okay, and the Mask pitching Exhum. Alright, that actually kind of helped me here. Okay, I'll let it resolve, because if this discard force, I'll just, I have just a second one. I think I have a chance now, guys. I think I have a chance now. Opponent is down to one reanimate only. And we have two Brazen Borrowers to bounce the Chancellor. So they might have kept not the best of the hands there. I mean, it is Chancellor on turn two. But it might be not enough against my hand. With two Petty Theft, it's much better than Medina Click now. Because we can bounce the Chancellor on three mana. Alright, do they play Reanimate here? I don't know why I hided it, sorry. I thought for a second they were going to play Reanimate for sure. Which, if they do, I think I have to force. Regardless of the fact that they have two Brazen Borrower for it. Maybe shouldn't, though. So they have Reanimate and Tarsplat Tyrant in hand. Okay, they pass. So they have Reanimate that I, for some reason, hided. Hidden. Alright, I'll play Mutavault. Because they don't know about the cavern, so let's just play Mutavault. Pay... play Aether Vial and pay for the Chancellor of a Nex. Not that Aether Vial is that good, but... Now I'm just not gonna bother countering the Chancellor here. I'm definitely not gonna bother countering the Chancellor. So they have a reanimating end. If they go reanimate, I'll let it resolve. Because I just bounce it. I think my friend is dead now. I think the way we win this game is because we have a... Alright, that was annoying. Because both of the cards my opponent... I mean, Tyrant for sure. But I don't think I can use a force for that, can I? Because they can draw a Grazebrand in the top two cards, and that is annoying. I think I'll go force pitch dates. Can I go force pitch Brazen Borrower? Because Daze is good on the flashback of looting, which they will eventually find, right? Although, if they draw two lands, they don't play into it. Yeah, I'm just gonna pitch that. I'm just gonna cast Brazen Borrower next turn, maybe. This is a weird play, forcing the Faithless Looting. Pretty sure it is. They don't know I have Cavern in my hand. Oh wow, they go for it. So glad they go for it. Yeah. Okay. So we say yes. We say yes. We play, it doesn't matter. Island. Sure. Then I play Petty Theft. Here. Pay two. And then I pay one more. I'm gonna gamble that it wouldn't draw land, I guess. That is what my opponent chose to play for. Not sure. Not sure if I agree with that. Alright, this is from the hand, right? From your hand, so I can't do that. Alright, another Faithless Looting. Sure, I mean, I can't do anything about that. So they will finally get rid of the Tyrant Tyrant. And maybe even of the... Wow, that was such a good draw. I guess they could have just drawn a land as well, I guess. So the two new cards in hand, and it's a Cabal Therapy on me. There's nothing I can do about it. The Brazen Borrower will leave the field. Will leave my hand, actually. Alright, now I guess I could lose. I don't have any more answer. If I let the first force resolve, I don't know. I don't know, guys. I thought I was going to win, but I guess double looting there is pretty annoying. I mean, also land would have been annoying. So it's not really that lucky what my opponent did. Alright, it goes to two. There's a Merfolk Pearl Trident. I could attack with a Mutavault, put them down to 10. Not the worst, right? Merfolk. not the worst. So I can cast this and play Master on an adventure. Wow. Alright. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. I'll play the Merfolk. I'll activate this and attack for 3. 0 cards, and the opponent goes to 9. Unfortunately, it doesn't have any island in play, so if they reanimate Grisabrand, they can also draw and then block. Oh, wow, they go the end step? Nice, 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 nice. Alright, that's gonna go to... stay on 2, probably, the vial. Again, I can't cast it, and they have, like, too many 2 drops. Do not stay on 2. Chalice. Interesting. Very interesting. I think I just chalice for 2 now, right? I mean, it doesn't stop anything for me, and it does stop like all the reanimation card from my opponent. I am going to play chalice on 2 here. If I play chalice on 1, do I stop the Fateless Looting? But this way, the reanimate is stopped because my opponent is on 7. And if I stop all the other cards, I think we got it. I think we got the win here. This is game 1, they can't have any reaction with my chalice. I think I'll just concede now. Because the game ends. Woo, we've got game 1. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. Okay, I have a lot of sideboard. Thankfully, I have Surgicals and Force. And I don't know about Vancer. I like Chalice. I'll board out Current Human Commander, Trunem Nemesis, and Aether Vials. I think I need more blue cards because of... yeah, I think I've done the same against Anaz and Tandrus, right? I could have Vancer over Current Heal Commander. But everything else looks okay. I mean, I could have Dismembering because they block with this with the thing, but I'm not sold on it. Let's go with this. Okay, we have a Surgical and a Relic. Can't really get better than this. And 2 Grizzly Bears. Yeah, I always joke about the Grizzly Bear. Alright, opponent kept 7 and goes chance. Oh, please don't combo me turn 1. My hand is too good to do to that turn 1. Please. Please don't kill me on turn 1. Alright, Fiddle Sodding is a good news. It's a good news. Grizzly Bear and Chancellor. Don't go pedal, please. Unmask myself. Sorry, me. I don't know why I said myself. They see a good end, although the relic is not as fast. Alright, so they still have the Chancellor reveal, so I'm not gonna play relic. Yes, yeah, just a reanimator. I mean, it's just the strongest combo I can form it by far. Sure, I concede, like, yeah. Alright, good game. Good game, good game. Let's do that for round game number 3. Last game of the league. Alright, let's do it. Let's do it, 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 let's do it. Okay, let's skip. Alright, you got a good end. Sure, you can reveal a Chancellor. I'm ready. No? No Chancellor? One time that I wanted you to play Chancellor, you don't play it? What's this? Alright. Island Pass. A perfect start. Swamp Pass. Another perfect start, apparently. Oh, Force of Negation. That's a good card. I'm gonna cast Silver Gill Adept. Aiming Merfolk. Revealing the Trickster. All the trick. Reveal all the trick to our opponent. Mm-hmm. Peel Trident. That's fine. We pass. Let's just draw... wow, don't even play Entombment of turn. Let's just draw Relic and just win the game. Boom. Swamp Swamp. What is it? Packeret? I remember playing Packeret in my Reanimator sideboard. Unmask. I think I want to hide the Surgical. They pitched Dark Reach. I think I want to hide the Surgical. So Exalian Mask as well. Cabal Therapy me. I will let that resolve. It doesn't make much difference. Like, if they named Surgical, it would have been the same. Like, they just unmask the Force and then take Surgical. I just lost the Trickster in the process, which doesn't really do too much. All right, Relic, please. Venser. All right, it's not the worst. It's not the worst. If I draw a land, actually, I can't cast it if I draw a land. It was supposed to name, no, it was supposed to name nothing. I did well. I could name Wizard, because I could cast both of these, but, like, you know, obviously I wasn't thinking about drawing Venser, Ship, or Savant. Okay, I can lose that with Force and Surgical on turn 3 of the game. Did this card, wow, Petalin Dark Ritual, that's so unlucky. But I'm also so glad that you were unlucky, opponent. Okay, let's play this. I think I'll top like this, yeah. I'll leave a Mono Ball top in case I draw, whatever. I mean, I can't cast both Super Guild Depth and Trickster. I guess I could. What is better to do? Yeah, I think it's just better to cast Super Guild Depth like this. Yeah, all right. I want to draw either Force of Will or Surgical Extraction. Okay, deck. No? All right. You're at 12. They just flashback the looting. This could be even lethal. Next turn, I deal 3, 6, 9, 11. They go to 1. Next turn, I go to 1. Yeah, I mean, sometimes you fizzle. I mean, like, they can just run him with Grizzle Brand this turn very easily. Like, very, very easily. Like, they have 3 cards in it. I don't know what they can be, but, like... Alright, looting. Discard 2 cards. Please don't discard any creature. Or if there has to be something, just Chancellor. Huh? Alright, they found the Grazer Brand and the Petal. Oh no. It's very likely just land reanimation card now. Pass the turn? Okay. Land for the win, please. Chalice. I think I wanna put them down to 1 now. They go to 1? They reanimate Grizzlebrand with a 2 mana card, and then, like, we have Merfolk Trickster to tap it and win. I think I'm going to do that. And also, putting them down to 1 means that they can correct the Marsh Floods. If that does say something. Alright, they go to 1, pass. Alright, I don't think they. I mean, they can reanimate Elish Norn. That is something they can do. But I don't know how. Unmask me. Sure. I guess they can now take the Trickster. Why does Unmask doesn't lose life? What did exile Sunset's Trophy? Sure. Alright, so they take the Merfolk Trickster. Oh, it takes Venser. Oh no. They go for the Elish Norn. Oh no. Please don't have it. Please don't have it, just concede. That was a bluff? Oh yes, it was a bluff! Oh my! Such a sweat! They didn't have it, oof! Alright, got 50 points, nice. Alright, that's the end of the video, hope you guys enjoyed it. I not particularly think that this deck is good, but if you have, you know, this deck in Modern, it's pretty cheap to bring Legacy as well, I guess. We went 2 and 3, 50 points. You know, it's not nothing. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll be back for more Legacy video next time. And as always, if you love the content, please press like and subscribe to the channel. Goodbye.